Now, the BJP's prime ministerial candidate Narendra Modi has spelled out his party's economic agenda, emphasizing on speedy yet sustainable economic growth. That is the need of the hour, according to him. And Priyal Gulyani joins us now from Delhi to really run us through the key takeaways from his speech yesterday. Priyal, you know, he has, of course, gone all out. He's wooing corporate India. He's also talking about what is going to be required if the new government has to revive growth. Run us through some of the other takeaways.
Well, in an audience comprising of economists, investors, India Inc., eagerly watching and waiting to understand what really is the economic vision and agenda as far as BJP is concerned, the prime ministerial candidate of BJP reiterated his economic vision in terms of bringing development and good governance. He continued to bring the entire Gujarat development model is and essentially pointing out to be replicating it perhaps for the country. He also emphasized on the fact that the Straits needs to be strengthened in terms of the overall growth that we are looking into the country. Continued also to question the policy of the government in terms of the kind of economy and the waste that he claims the 10 years have really caused under the leadership in UPA. However, in terms of concrete economic agendas, there were, of course, not much details that really came out during this session. However, there was a mixed response in terms of the audience who did say that the economic vision did give an important indication, which as it is, perhaps the India Inc. is really keenly watching. But the concern of a fractured mandate looms large for the investors and the audience that we interacted with, and also pointed out that, of course, there is some more concrete measures and economic agendas that really need to come out now from this table.
That's it, Priyal. You know, hang in there. Joining me now is Suman Sinha, the chairman and CEO of Renew Power. You know, yesterday, of course, saw the attendance of corporates across the board. It also saw several leaders from the G20 and the who's who coming in as far as policy goes. So let me start off by asking you first and foremost, you know, we saw announcements on both wind energy and solar energy, and that's something which is close to your heart and the industry that you represent. What was your key takeaway really from that?
I think, Sunanda, thanks a lot, first of all, for having me on your show this morning. I think the session yesterday with Narendra Modi ji was actually very interesting because I think, you know, everybody is talking about what are the specific steps that he's going to undertake. But I think he sort of sidestepped that question and that approach. And he really talked about the fact that more than specific economic policies, what we require is better governance. And of course, things like fiscal deficit and the current account deficit and the macroeconomic numbers all need to be managed and need to come into alignment. But I think over and above that, the most fundamental thing as per him is how do we make sure that there is better alignment among policymakers, whether at the central level or at the state level, going forward? And how do we make sure that things actually get done? And I think if you talk to most corporate India people right now, that in fact is the single biggest issue, which is that things are not getting done, policies are not sort of getting moved forward, and implementation is where the problem is. As far as the wind and solar references were concerned, obviously that's really good from our standpoint, because I think the Planning Commission is also in the process of releasing a document which indicates the fact that India is going to have very significant shortages of energy going forward, and the only way to resolve some of these issues is through much faster and more sustained use of renewable energy, Modi ji talked about as well. And he also talked about the whole issue of sustained development and leaving having a development paradigm that works for our future generations as well. All of which works very well, obviously, from our industry standpoint.
Okay. You know, I will come to the policy paralysis bit in just a short while, but I want to press the point that I'm talking about electricity shortage. You know, we've seen a recent report coming out from FICCI which says that almost $68 billion of India's GDP has been lost because of electricity generation shortages. And he says he wants to replicate the Gujarat model that they've seen where they're energy sufficient. Do you think a Modi-led BJP government will really be able to fix these shortages?
Yeah, I think, Sunanda, you know, the things that need to be done are not that difficult. I think there are two or three fundamental issues. One is that all the projects in the conventional space that have got stuck right now need to be unblocked somehow or the other, either through better and faster coal access, whether through imports or otherwise. The second thing is there are a number of banks that have lent to a lot of these conventional projects which are now in problems. Those projects, once they start moving, will start opening up again banks' credit appetite. So I think that is the second thing. And third thing, as I mentioned earlier, is that we really need to give a huge boost to the whole area of renewable energy, because ultimately, you know, we can't keep importing. Today we import more than $100 billion of oil. We are beginning to import more and more of our coal. You know, as a country, we can't do that. We can't sustain these kind of numbers. And I think energy security, energy independence means that we have to, I think, move forward much more aggressively on both solar energy as well as wind energy. And I think that is something that Gujarat has really shown the way in, you know, because they were the first state that came out with almost 1,000 megawatts of solar power. And I think that's the way to go. I think we have to go for scale. I think we have to really try to change the energy paradigm by providing a much broader set of options available in terms of our energy basket. And I think that's where Gujarat has been successful. They've got a lot of wind. They've got a lot of solar. Public sector enterprises there have done fairly well. And ultimately, what they've been able to do is to provide 24/7 power to all the villages. And I think that is really what needs to happen across India as well, for which we need to improve the grid. We need to make sure that more energy is provided and generated across India. And there is better pricing for the power at the consumer end, which is something that, of course, some of the other political parties seem to be shying away from. But that is an essential part of this whole equation as well. So hopefully, under a Modi-led government, some of these things could get addressed. And, you know, I think in one of the papers I read, the fact that they're trying to come out with this 24/7 energy as being one of the key sort of guiding principles of the new economic plank.
Okay. You know, Mr. Sinha, one of the other headlines from yesterday's speech was about the Prime Minister working in tandem with the states, you know, an entire model of economic federalism, if you want to call it that. The GST, of course, has been on the back burner for just a bit. Do you think that if this model is successful, the GST, there is some hope for that?
Yeah, Sunanda, you know, I think it's for all of us who do business across India, where especially in sectors like power, which are concurrent subjects and therefore subject to both central guidelines as well as state activity, you know, it's extremely frustrating very often that the center says something and the states do something totally different. And across all the states, there are differences in the way certain policies are implemented. So I think having much better alignment between the Prime Minister and the state chief ministers would absolutely be welcome across a broad swathe of areas, whether it's power, whether it's GST. Now, at the same time, having said that, the reality is that you have different political parties of the state and different political parties of the center, and therefore there are all sorts of political issues that will keep coming up. So some of these things are easier said than done, and so therefore I think that while, of course, it will be great if the PM and the state chief ministers can all work with each other and pass important legislation which makes business a lot easier, which improves tax collections like the GST, unfortunately some of these things will be hostage to political dynamics. And, you know, any amount of, you know, what we may wish otherwise, that is going to carry on being the case. But certainly, I think it's a refreshing thought. What he said yesterday is that instead of the PM and his cabinet, really it should be the PM and his state chief ministers who should really form the bulwark for policy implementation across India. And that's really an interesting thought. And whether it works in practice or not remains to be seen.
Okay, one quick last thought before we let you go. He also spoke about the need to do away with multiple laws, obviously referring also to the retrospective tax amendments that we saw. But the question is on effective legislation of any new structure he puts in place. What are your comments on that?
You know, I think it's again something that all Indians understand, the fact that we have way too many laws. The implementation of them is always extremely spotty depending on who the recipient of that implementation happens to be and who the enforcer happens to be. So I think the fact that we have fewer laws and the fact that we enforce them in a more transparent manner and in a more uniform and consistent manner, where the rules of the game are clearer for everybody right up front, but there are fewer rules at the same time in the game, I think that will absolutely be welcome. I think because all of us suffer from a lot of these laws, which, you know, Mr. Suresh Prabhu, who was there as well, said that even though we have so many laws, There is still a lot of lawlessness in India, and what we require is less laws going forward.